the miracle that happened in New Jersey. You might walk it down so people can see it and leave it up here. Now, some of you may know that 200, 250 years ago in England and also in this country, when Christian preachers preached, they often preached a real message of hate and fear. They preached that only a few people would be saved by God, and that God was very angry and would send most of human beings to hell. But there was one man in England named John Murray. And John Murray was a good, solid Methodist preacher. And he was sent by some of his people in his church to help some people who had become heretics. Do you know what heretic means? Heretic's a big word. It's often used to say that people don't believe. But heretic is also a word that means that people choose what to believe. And so John Murray was sent off to bring these heretics back into the Methodist fold, because they were believing that God was loving and God would save everyone. So he went off to visit these heretics, these universalist heretics. And he talked with them and talked with them. And the more he talked, the more he listened, the more he thought, they've got it right. That really is. God is love. And so he went back to his Methodist church and said, here, these universalists are right, we've got to join them. Well, the universalists said, John Murray, you're a heretic, you're out of here. But he was a good preacher, so he preached universal salvation all over London. He was married and he had a child, and while he was doing his preaching, his wife got very, very sick, and his son got very, very sick. And they both died, even though John Murray spent everything he had to try to bring them health. And he ended up in something called debtor's prison because he didn't have any money. Well, a brother helped him get out of debtor's prison, and the arrangement was that if he left the country, he would be able to be out of debtor's prison. So he got on a boat called the Hand in Hand, and the Hand in Hand was sailing for the New World. There wasn't even the United States there. It was just America. It was this strange new world. And John Murray said, I'm leaving everything behind. I'm not a universalist anymore. I'm not a preacher anymore. I lost my family. I'm going to the new world to start a whole new life. So he got on a boat that was a sailboat. Didn't maybe look quite like this sailboat. And the sailboat crossed the Atlantic Ocean. And it took a long time in those days to cross the Atlantic Ocean. And when he got to the East Coast, he had some boat trouble. But I have to tell you about a man who was already in the Americas at that point. His name was Thomas Potter. And Thomas Potter was a very well-to-do farmer. He was a very successful man. But he wasn't educated. He never went to school. His parents didn't think it was a good idea to send him to school. But he was very smart, and he loved talking about religion. And he knew in his country, most of the preachers were talking about sending everybody to hell. But he heard there were ideas, different ideas. And he loved religion so much that he would invite people to come into his house and talk with him about it. And after a while, his wife Mary got a little tired of all these people filling up her fancy parlor. And she said, Thomas Potter, you've just got to go outside. So what Thomas Potter did was build a chapel. And he built a chapel mostly with his own hands because he believed that a preacher would come who would preach universal salvation. So Potter's chapel sat there. And lots of people asked if they could use it. And lots of people asked if they could have it. And he said, nope, you can't have it until you prove to me that God believes that your faith is the faith of God. And so the Methodists used it and the Baptists used it, and his neighbors began to laugh. And years went by. It was 10 years since he built this chapel, and he still believed his preacher was coming, but none came. Well, about that time, the ship, the Hand in Hand, got stuck on a sandbar outside the Jersey shore. And the captain of the ship sent John Murray with some sailors into the main room to get some food, because they knew they were going to be there for a while. And so John Murray asked around, where can I get food? And the people said, oh, you've got to go talk to Thomas Potter. He's well off. He'll have some food. He'll have some fish that he can sell you. So John Murray went down the road, found Thomas Potter's farm, and there was Thomas Potter sitting there with a great big basket of fish beside him. And so John Murray said, well, may I buy some fish for my sailors? And Thomas Potter said, no, you can't buy fish. And John Murray was a little surprised, and Thomas Potter went on to say, I got them free from the ocean. God gave them to me. They're yours. And by the way, come on back later and talk to me after you get your sailors settled. So John Murray got the sailors all settled in a nice inn with their fish, and he went back to talk to Thomas Potter. And Thomas Potter greeted and said, John Murray, I've been waiting for you for so long. And John Murray said, I was just here an hour ago. And Thomas Potter said, no, I believe you are my universalist preacher. Well, John Murray argued with him. They talked religion for hours. And finally, Thomas Potter weaseled out of him that, yes, he was a preacher. He was a universalist. But John Murray said, I'm not doing that anymore. No way, you can't get me to preach in your chapel. But Thomas Potter finally convinced him, this was on a Wednesday, that if the wind hadn't changed by Sunday in 4 days, and the ship was still stuck in the sandbar, then John Murray agreed he would come and preach in the chapel. And sure enough, the wind blew and the ship got stuck on that sandbar and stayed stuck. And so John Murray came, he was good to his word, came to the chapel on Sunday morning. And the afternoon before, Thomas Potter sent out to the highways and the byways to all his friends and neighbors and said, come, come, come. My preacher has come. We're going to hear about universalism. And so they filled the chapel. And John Murray started preaching that God is love, that everybody is saved, everybody belongs. And he preached and preached. And in those days, sermons tended to be about 3.5 hours long. So he preached and preached. And the more he preached, the more he regained his own faith. And when the sermon was over and the service was done, some of his sailors ran up and they said, the wind has changed, the ship is free. And so John Murray went, got back on his ship, he sailed up to New York and he headed north, and he founded the first Universalist Church in Boston, Massachusetts. And so that's the miracle that happened in good luck in Jesus.